Thank you. melody is a very quantum. And the first line of the hymn says, the angel Gabriel of heaven came, his eyes like flames, and his wings like drifts of snow. And what an image that must have been. Of course, none of us were there at that occasion. But the hymn does remind us very much so of this time of year. And of course, at this time of year, we must be very close to the Blessed Mother. After the Mass this morning, I went downstairs, and one lady, she was asking me if I was familiar with the custom of the Orvate, which is a series of Masses done early in the morning, 6 o'clock in the morning, Mass offered in honor of the Blessed Mother, only by candlelight. And I was familiar with the tradition. I've never experienced it, but I've read about it. And we have to remember that all of this reminds us that in Advent, we truly have to be close to the Blessed Mother. She who had fear at first, and the angel said to her, "Did not be afraid." And we repeat those words when we pray the Hail Mary. We pray that angelic salutation. For only her, only she, who received that message from God, then received that peace from above, and she was able to go forth and bring and carry forth the Savior for us all. Thankfully, Marian devotion does seem to be where it should be once again. There was a period not all that long ago where Marian devotion was not so popular in our faith because of misunderstandings from the Second Vatican Council. But it's not true. Mary takes on a special role, and she should be and must be a part of our daily Advent journey. And so I would encourage all of you to pray the Angelus or the Rosary or some other Marian devotion regularly during Advent. I did say at Mass this morning, one of the greatest prayers we can say in ancient prayer, a very simple, "Come, Lord Jesus." And that we can pray while we're sitting on the bus or walking down the street, and that's fine, that's good. But let us not forget that Mary definitely needs to be first place in our heart during this Advent season, so that she can lead us. She's always the one who points us to our Savior. And so the more we turn to her, the more and more she will help us go to our Savior, and to not be afraid of those things which can take us away from Him, especially during this time of year, when so much can take us away from the true meaning of Christmas. If we stay close to her, she will point, and she will say to us, "Don't worry about that, don't get upset about this, stay away from that, come to my Son." And she will take us. She will take us to Him, which is where we need to be during this time of year. Or if we want to begin this new liturgical year off on the right foot and allow room for our Savior to come to us, then let us start by Mary's intercession, asking her to give us her Son.